Hello, praise the Lord. My name is Pastor Emmanuel Musisi, and I'm standing here at Busia Miracle Center grounds. And I'm very excited to encourage you this evening. But as Busia Miracle Center family, we want to encourage you, the people of God out there, that we are still together. And we still love you, and God loves you. And some of these days I've been praying and waiting upon the Lord because I've got more time to pray. I've got more time to read the Word of God. And every time I read the Word of God, I'm encouraged as a Christian, as a believer. And I also encourage you because when you read the Word of God, it nourishes you, it encourages you. You hear the best way God can ever speak to us as Christians is through His Word, because He spoke to us several times. Right from Genesis up to Revelation, God has been speaking to us. And when we add on prayer, you speak unto the Lord like your Father. Every time when I go back in the evening at home, I get some time. And I go outside and I look in the sky, I look at the stars, I look at the moon, and I begin to pray. So I want to encourage you as a personal devotion in your life. Continue doing the things. Though you are not coming to church right now physically, but you are the church of Christ. You are the temple of the living God. You can do whatever you can ever do when the things which you do when you're in church, like praising, reading the Bible, listening to the Word of God, you can do them exactly when you are at home, when you are around your courtyard. For example, if you have a small room, you can use your sitting room. You can read your Bible. You can praise the Lord. You can call your children, come together, and you begin praise the Lord because you are the church of Christ. The Bible says, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against that church. You are the church of Christ, and God is going to bless you when you do the thing. So, I go back home and I get some time and I'm praying and I look at the stars, I look at the sky, I look at the moon, and I thank God for the great things that He does in my life. Some of those days I was thinking, way back when I was so young, because right now I'm around 48 years, and when I was still a Catholic boy, very little, I joined the ministry in the Catholic Church, and I love to serve the Lord. And as I've been thinking about a few things in the Bible says, in your presence, there is fullness of joy. At your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. I enjoyed ministry. I loved God. And I could go to the church and I could serve those priests there. And we had the little boys that follow. You people who know the Catholic systems. But right from there, I was thinking that God knew me. God knew my ministry. He counted me faithful long ago, before I even knew about salvation through Jesus Christ, way back in the 80s when I was serving those priests there, when I was in the church. And right now, I'm preaching the gospel. Right now, I'm a pastor at Busia Miracle Center Church. And so, wherever you are, God knows you. God loves you. God sees you very many years from now. Maybe He sees your future. This is what you are going to become. So don't get worried. And as you pray, God begins to reveal your destination. He begins to reveal the purposes that you have got in Him. And don't lose heart. Even right now, where you are, continue praying. Continue reading the Bible. And right now, you, like a minister of God, you, the believer, you, the person that has been believing God for a thing in your life, for a job. Some people have lost jobs. Don't lose courage. God is at the throne of mercy. He's listening to our prayers. When Jesus was teaching about prayer, He said men ought to pray and should not lose their heart. So right now, it's time for us to pray. In fact, we are having even more time to pray. I don't want to go so much into, you know, really in the Word of God and many other things, reading the Bible, but I just want to speak casually unto you, like, in this season, rejoice in the Lord. The Bible says, in His presence, keep the presence of God. In His presence, there is fullness of joy. When Jesus called His disciples to become the apostles, He called them first of all to be with Him. God loves you to be in fellowship with Him. As you read the Word of God, as you pray, as you fellowship with your family, the presence of God should be kept in your life. You should begin to get excited on the inside of your spirit. Because right now, God is doing more than ever before. I've been thinking about a few things in this season where some people are at home. What were we doing? Rushing going to cities, boarding planes, doing a lot of businesses, speaking loud. What were we doing? It was so much of struggle, anxiety, and trouble. But right now, when you go back and you begin to think and meditate about what God has done for you, there is that innermost joy that always oozes out of your spirit, man. And you feel the presence of God right inside you. And I want to tell you, God is going to begin answering everything you've been praying for. And I want to tell you, the peace of God is going to begin flooding your heart. Keep the presence of God in your life. Keep the presence of God even in your family. At times I come here to church, pick up videos and share with 1, 2, 3 people because of the social distancing and because of the directives that are coming from the authorities. But even then, we keep ourselves in the Word of God. And we are excited for this season. We thank God so much for this season because we are not lacking. God has provided for us. Some people have been asking, where do those people get food? God is a provider. The Bible says, my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. As long as you believe God, God owns the cattle over 1,000 hills. Silver and gold belongs to him. The healing that you need in your body all belongs to God. Everything that you desire in this life, the answer is God. The Bible says in Jeremiah chapter 33 and verse 3, it says, call upon me in the times of trouble and I will answer you. God has got your answer. All answers, if you want answer, financial answers, if you want academic answers, if you want social answers, answers for your family, you are going to find them in the presence of God. Keep the presence of God. Enjoy the presence of God. We love you so much. We want you to succeed and prosper. So even as Busia Miracle Center family, we love you so much and we keep the fellowship. Continue calling one another. Continue encouraging one another. We know God is working out something for you. God is about to answer you who has been calling upon the name of the Lord. God is just by your side. God loves you. He came all the way from heaven, come and die for your sin and to set you free. So where you are, wherever you are watching from, be of courage. Be encouraged in the Lord. The Lord is your deliverer. The Bible says in Psalms 121, the Lord is your keeper. He that keeps you will not sleep. He will not slumber. He's going to be with you for the rest of your life. He that started a good work in you is faithful. He's going to complete that work. He has never forgotten you. God remembers your life. God remembers everything that you have ever done for him. We love you very much. Continue watching these programs. We love you very much. Continue following us on Facebook and on WhatsApp. This is Pastor Emmanuel Musisi. God bless you very much.